wastewater disposal of produced water options are underground injection control wells, on-site treatment such as evaporation, recycling or reuse. A potential emerging problem with underground injection control wells is that recent studies suggest that UIC wells can cause earthquakes. This has been observed in Oklahoma, Texas, Arkansas, Ohio, and Colorado. More on this later in the course. So what is produced water? It is water that comes to the surface with oil and gas following completion operations and during production. It contains many chemical constituents, high salt contents, high dissolved solids, high electrical conductivity, oil and grease, compounds of many hydrocarbons and other organic materials, toxicity from various natural inorganic and organic compounds or chemical additives, naturally occurring radioactive material also are possible in produced water. Wastewater composition, the quality, the duration, vary considerably between shale plays and even vary geographically within the same play. In the Barnett, for instance, there are large volumes of produced water and TDS and chloride increase significantly over time. In the Fayetteville, there is relatively low concentrations of chloride, magnesium, and total dissolved solids. In the Haynesville, there is high calcium concentrations, magnesium, chloride, total dissolved solids, and total suspended solids. In the Marcellus, you have high sodium, calcium, magnesium, chloride, total dissolved solids, and high specific conductance, and often high barium and strontium as well. The salinity of produced water increases over time as the percentage of formation water increases in the water that comes to the surface. Produced water volumes from waste streams from oil and gas production. Worldwide estimates are 77 billion barrels per year. In the U.S., 21 billion barrels per year. 57 million barrels per day, or 2.4 billion gallons per day. Resources related to these statistics are in the resource section for the course. The main constituent of produced water that causes impacts is salt. Other constituents can create problems in certain settings. So what are the potential adverse impacts of produced water? There are different impacts at different locations. Depends on the level of key chemical constituents and the nature of the water and other substrate into which the produced water is released. Salt can contaminate soils near wellheads, pipelines, and other facilities. It can kill plants, it damages the soil, and thus impacts future plant growth. In terms of spills and leaks, large spills can move into surface water bodies. Toxic compounds and oil and grease can damage aquatic life. Leakage from tanks or impoundments can soak into the ground and enter groundwater. In addition to harming soils, large releases of produced water may soak deep into the ground and enter sources of drinking water. Discharges of salty produced water into freshwater bodies will cause damage to aquatic animals and plants. High total dissolved solid waters can result in golden algae outbreaks and fish kills. Discharges of oil and grease and toxic chemicals can cause damage in both fresh and salt water. Recycling of flowback and produced wastewater is becoming more common in many plays. With up to 10 million gallons of water used per well and water supplies scarce in some areas, several companies are now recycling their wastewaters. This strategy can save money on water purchases and reduce environmental impacts from disposal. Most simply use sedimentation and filtration of wastewater and then mix with fresh water. Some are looking at more complete treatment and reuse options. For example, Chesapeake Energy has something called the Aqua Renew program, which involves not only filtration and dilution, but an evaporative reduction and solidification system. More information on this technique is in the resource section. The recycling challenge is really one of water quality. With fresh water, there's no problems with frack jobs, no problems with chemistry. It's all well understood. With produced water and flowback water, minerals in that water can cause scale. Minerals can therefore interfere with the frack gel and impact the effective proppant delivery. Water quality varies widely from one play and even within a play. We need more studies to determine water quality limits for recycling. Need results that are specific to portions of the basin where the activities are greatest. These results will point to the type of water treatment needed. Environmental regulations are becoming more and more stringent. For instance, air emission rules now apply to recycling pits, and many states now require baseline monitoring.